Hello everybody, today we are going to start a new lesson, that is statistics. Okay, already we have taken some information in class 8, okay, in lesson data heavy. Okay, we have learned how to find out mean, how to find out median, how to find out mode, okay, how to present the given data with the help of tabular form. Okay, that such type of basic information we have taken. In class 9, we are going to see the same topics with different manner. Some more information we are going to collect. Understood? So today we are going to see the concept number one. Okay. So in that, these are the sub points. So we will see what is the meaning of each and every sub point. Okay. So first one is data. What is meant by data? Data means a set of information which is in the form of numerical form, set of information. Suppose one example we will see for this all the sub concepts. Suppose I will take the marks of mathematics, understood, from all the students. So then that is the data which I have collected. Understood? So such type of collection is known as data. Okay, there are two types. First one is primary data. And second one is secondary data. Understood? So what is mean by primary data? Primary data is what? Which I have collected directly. Which I have collected or investigator collected in directly from the students or any other sources. Okay, suppose I want marks of mathematics, then I will collect from the students. So that is primary data. Okay, primary data. Understood? So secondary data is what is mean by secondary data? If the same marks I will take from the teachers, subject teachers, if I am class teacher and I want all subject marks of my class, if I will ask directly you students, then that is the primary data. If I will ask to the teachers, subject teachers, then that is the secondary data, because that is I have not collected by me, okay, by directly from the students. I have collected from someone else. So that is secondary data. If I do not have time, I have collected some information from the newspaper, okay, from the net, understood? So that is not directly collection, so that is known as secondary data. Okay, so there are two types, primary data and secondary data. Okay, second is collection of data. Just now I told you one example. If I want marks of mathematics of class test, then I will ask directly to the students and I will collect the marks. That is the collection of data. Understood? If I am class teacher, I will ask all the students to give all subject marks. Okay, to prepare the result. Okay, so that is also a type of collection. Okay, so when I will collect all subject marks, then only I can prepare the result. Okay, so that is the collection of data. Okay. Third thing is presentation of data. Presentation of data we have seen how to present the data. Means anyhow we can see here. If I want to write your marks, then I will write serially. Okay. Or I can write in ascending order, or I can write in descending order. Anyhow. Okay, so that is the presentation of data. Descending order. Okay. If I want to prepare result, then serially I will take roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that I will prepare result. Okay. If I want to show these marks to my seniors, or principal is asking, show the score or result of your class, I want ascending order. Okay. So I can show it like this. This lowest score will come first. Lowest, then it will increase, and roll number, ranker first will come in the last. Okay, here completely opposite, ranker first will come upside, and then 1, 2, 3, ranker 2, ranker 3, ranker 4, like that. Means within a fraction you will get the idea who is first, how many students are below average, that we can understand from this. So presentation of that data is important. Then it gives us an exact idea, okay, about the data. Okay, next thing is frequency. Frequency is what is mean by frequency? The number of times the observation occurs. The number of time observation occurs. That is known as frequency. Okay. So suppose here 3, 2, 2, 1, 3, 4, 1. What is the frequency of 3? 1, 2, 3 came 2 times. So, frequency of 3 is 2. What is the frequency of 2? Frequency of 2 is 2 because 2 occurs 2 times. What is the frequency of 1? Also 2. What is the frequency of 3? 4, 1 time because 4 came only 1 time. So, that is known as frequency. Okay, generally we use the frequency word in our daily life also. Okay. So, next one is frequency distribution. Here this is a little bit new topic one. Frequency distribution. Okay. So, first is inclusive. There are two types. Inclusive. And second is exclusive. Okay. We will see these things in the examples in detail. Then that time you will understand. Okay. Inclusive. Discontinuous. Okay, and exclusive is what? Continuous. Okay, so these are another word for this, inclusive and exclusive. Okay, so just I am giving you one idea. Suppose classes are there 10 to 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40, like that. These are the class examples, 31 to 40. Okay, this is one type. Okay, discontinuous. Why these are discontinuous? Because 10 and 20 is here. Okay, after that 21, 30. There is no any continuity. Understood? So 10, 20, 21, 30, 31, 40. Okay, but if I will like this, right? This 10 to 21, 21 to 31, and 31 to 40. Okay, like that. If suppose I will write, then this is continuous. This is continuous. 10 to 21. 21 is there here also and here also. Okay. 31 here also and here also. But here 20, here directly 21. Understood? So this is known as inclusive, discontinuous, and this is known as exclusive, which is continuous. Okay. This is the different basic difference between this. Okay. While doing examples, we will see in detail. Next is frequency distribution of ungrouped data. Frequency distribution of ungrouped data. Okay, so frequency distribution of ungrouped data means we have seen tabular form. So here I am taking one example, 3, 2, 1, 6, 4, 9, 2, okay, like that numbers are given, this is the data. Okay, so now I want to write in tabular form, so how I will write, what will come here, tally marks and here. Number of observations, here observations. Okay, so here how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. It is not there, 9. Okay, how many times 1 is given? Only one time. So one line I can put. Okay, one vertical line. Then 2 how many times? 1, 2. Or we can go like this also. Cancel 1 to 1. 3. I will put here one line. 2 already I have taken. 1 already I have taken. 6. Then 4. Then 9. Okay. Like that, with the help of tally marks. Till last year we have seen. Okay. Till last year we have seen how to present a ungrouped data. Frequency distribution of ungrouped data. This is ungrouped data. That is the distribution. Okay, so this is with the help of tabular form or table, we can say. Okay, so this was the basic information about concept number one. Okay, so we will see one example. So see here, students. Now we are going to see one problem which is depend on the. Just now we have seen some concept which is related to those concepts. Okay, this problem is taken from NCERT textbook. This is from NCERT exercise. Okay, so see carefully what is given. The distance in kilometer of 40 female engineers from their residence to their place of work were found as follows. Okay, this is given. The distance from their residence to place of work. 5 kilometer, 3 kilometer, 10 kilometer, 20, 25 kilometer, like that it is given. Okay, construct a group frequency distribution. Construct a group frequency distribution table with class size 5 for the data given below, given above. Taking the first interval 0 to 5, they have told us 0 to 5. Okay, 0 to 5, and here it is given phi not included. Phi not included is what? Suppose here some observations are there. 0, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, but 5 will not come in between 0 to 5. It will come 5 to 10, next interval. Okay, so that is the meaning of this bracket. Then what main features will you observe? Okay, so here first we will start distance in kilometer, tally marks, frequency, like that. It is means as usual we have taken. Now 0 to 5, that interval we need to take here. Okay, then next will be 5 to 10, then 10 to 15, 15 to 30, 30 to, sorry, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30, and 30 to 35. Why last I have taken 30 to 35? Because last observation is 32. Last observation is 32. Okay. So that I have seen before starting this. Then only I can take the intervals. Okay. And here total. So here see 0 to 5 is 5 minus 0 is 5. 10 minus 5 is 5. Okay. All intervals are same. The difference between upper and lower limit. This is a lower limit. This is upper limit. Upper and lower limit difference is same. Okay, tally marks. Now as usual we need to take, suppose now 5, this is the important 5, where it will come 5, it will come in second point, so it will come here. Okay, so 5, 3, where it will come 3, here. Okay, then 10, 10 will come, 10 will not come in 5 to 10, 10 will come into 10 to 15, so it will come like this. Okay, then 20, 20 will come 20 to 25. Next, this it will not come in 50 to 20. Okay, so 20 to 25. It will come. Okay, so like that 25. 25 will come 25 to 30. It will come here. Okay, then 11. 11 will come. 11 will come. This we can write very easily 10 to 50. It will come here. Okay, then 13. 13 will come 10 to 15. Then 7 will come, 7 will come 0, 5 to 10, 7 will come here. Then 12, then 12 and 31, 12 is, 12 will come here. And 31, 31 will come 30 to 30. Like that tally marks we need to do. Okay. So, we can do this easily and then we have to try to total. Tally marks I have done. So, we can do directly from this. Now, I need to count this. How many are there? What is the frequency? 0 to 5, 5. Then 5 plus 5, 10 plus 1, 11. 5 plus 5, 10 plus 1, 11. 5 plus 4, 9. 1, only 1, 1 in here, 2. So now we need to tally our total. Okay, because what is given? The distance of 40 human engineers from residence to place of work is given. So the total should come 40. Then only our answer is correct. Or frequency or tally mass is correct. Then 11 plus 11, 22 plus 5, 27 plus 9, 36, 37, 38, 39, and 40. Okay, so here it is 40. Understood? So our answer is correct. Now, one more question they have told us, what main features do you observe? What main features? Okay, so here from this 0 to, means suppose we can see here more females are there. So here we can say, 5 to 15 or 5 to 20, how many, between 5 to 5 kilometer to 20 kilometer, how many female are there? 11 plus 11, 22 plus 9, 30. Okay, here is here more number of female are there. Okay, so 5 is 30 to 35 kilometer, how many female are there? 2. So these are the observations. So this we need to write in the last. Okay, so this example we have taken on the basic information, which already you have done this. Okay. Okay. See here. So now we are going to see next point, that is grouped frequency distribution. Okay. So this is a completely new topic we are going to learn. So see here, what is grouped frequency distribution? I have taken here one example and some concepts which are related to this. Okay. How to prepare. Procedure to arrange given data into class intervals. Okay, so
all those things we will see in detail. Okay, so what is here, it is given marks obtained by 30 students. Marks obtained by 30 students in a specific subject, that is given. Okay, that we have taken to clear this concepts. Okay, so now the procedure to arrange given data into class intervals, how to prepare class intervals, okay, or how to convert the data into class intervals, that we are going to see. Okay, so in that, first is arrange. What is first one? Arrange. So range, what is mean by range? Range means we are going to find out highest observation minus lowest observation. Okay, highest observation. Suppose you will see here, what is the highest score? What is the highest score? So here highest score is 93. Highest score is 93. That is highest observation. Okay, and lowest score. Lowest score is here, I think it is 35. Okay, less than 35 you will not get. So that is the lowest score. Okay, so the range means highest observation, highest observation minus lowest observation. Okay, so what will come range? Range is equal to 93 minus 35. 93 minus 35. So it will be 58. Okay, so range of this data is 58. Understood? So that is the initial state. That is the initial steps. Range means what? Highest observation minus lowest observation. Okay. So here highest observation is here highest marks is 93 and lowest marks is 35. So the difference between that is equal to the range. So range is 58. Okay. So this was the first thing. Then class size. Class size. We need to decide about class size. Okay. That we need to decide according to the spread of this data. According to the spread of this data. So let we decide the class size. Let class size be 10. Class size be 10. Okay, we are taking here 10. We have taken 10. Okay. So now afterwards this reference we are going to use. Okay. So see here we have decided to take class size 10. Number of classes. Now we need to decide about number of classes. Number of classes is equal to its range divided by class size. Number of classes is equal to range divided by class size. Range divided by class size. Okay. So what is the range? Range is 58 and class size we have taken 10. Okay. So the range is equal to 58. Divided by class size is 10. So what will be your answer? 5.8. Okay, 5.8. So how many classes are required? 5.8 we will say here it is say 6. 5.8 is approximately equal to 6. Understood? So we will prepare here number of classes are 6. How to find out number of classes? Range divided by class size. Range divided by class size. Understood? So range divided by class size we got answer in decimal 5.8 and 5.8 is approximately equal to 6. So number of classes are 6. We will consider number of classes 6. Get it? So here I am taking the 6 classes. Okay. How to find out that? Understood everybody? Okay. Now class intervals. Class interval is also related to this. Class intervals. How to construct class intervals? How to take class intervals? Here a range is, class size is 10 and minimum marks, lowest score is 35. Okay, so class intervals, to decide class intervals, what we can do? We need two, lower limit and upper limit. We have discussed just before this example, we have seen that is 0 to 5. This is the interval. This was the interval. 0 was the lower limit and 5 was the upper limit. So how to decide class intervals? Okay, so class interval is equal to, how to decide CL? Lower limit is 35. Lower 35. 35 to, what will come? 35 to 44. 35 to 44. Okay. Next will come 45 to 54. 45 to 54. Okay. After that it will come 54, 55 to 64. Okay, how many are required? How many classes are required? 6 classes. So next will come 65 to 75. Okay, then 75 to 84 and 85 to 94 and 93 is the highest. So this is the last class, sixth one class. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, why? How we have decided this? 35 is the lowest. 35 to 44. Why 44? Because our size is, class size is 10. Okay, 35 to 44. This is 35, 36, 37, 38, 39 to 44. Means the class size is 10. Okay, so 35 to 44, 45 to 54, 55 to 64, 65 to 74. Okay, and 75 to 84, 85 to 94. Okay, so we can understand here, this is continuous or discontinuous? Definitely this is discontinuous. Understood? Discontinuous why? Because here see, 34, 44 is here, and here directly 45 is there. Okay, so here 44 and here 44. Okay, upper limit of first interval and lower limit of second interval, where it is same, that is continuous, but here it is discontinuous. Understood? So 35, if someone got 35 marks, that is going to come here. Someone will get 44 marks, that is also going to come here. Understood? So this is discontinuous class intervals. Okay, so this was the number of classes for class intervals. These are the class intervals. 6 class intervals are required. Okay, then maximum and minimum value. Maximum and minimum value. Maximum value is here. Here in first interval, if we are thinking about this first interval, minimum value, this someone will get 35 marks, that is going to come here. Okay, and suppose someone will get 45 marks, then it is going to come here. 45 to 54. That is, that will come completely in this interval. Okay, so that is known as maximum and minimum value. Understood? So after this, we are going to see tally marks. Tally marks. Okay, tally marks already we have seen. Then tally marks, then class limit. Class limit. Class limit we see. About 35 and 44, this is the lower class limit. This is known as lower class limit. And this is known as upper class limit. Upper class limit. Class limit. Okay. Lower class limit and upper class limit, that is known as class limit. Understood? Now we will see how to present this data. Okay, for continuous distribution. For continuous, this is discontinuous, and afterwards we will see for continuous. Okay, so see here carefully, frequency distribution of marks. Frequency distribution of marks. Frequency distribution, distribution of marks. Frequency distribution of marks. Okay, so what was our class intervals? 35 to class intervals. First it will come class intervals. Okay, second one will come tally marks. Tally marks, and third one will come total frequency. Frequency. Okay, so class intervals, we have taken 6 class intervals. Why 6 class intervals? That also we have seen. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so first our interval, first interval was 35 to 40. Okay, then 45 to 54, then 55 to 64, 65 to 74, 75 to 84, 85 to 94. Okay, so these are the class intervals. Okay, and here it will come total. Okay, now tally marks we need to do. Okay, so here 84, 75 and 48. Okay, directly it will come 84, where it will come 84, it will come here only, 75 to 84, okay, this is discontinuous. So 84 will come here only. When these two are same, lower limit and upper limit of second class, that time it will come in x, that we are going to see again for this data only. So 84 will come here. Then 75 will come here. Then 93 will come this column. Then 48 will come here. Then 60 will come 52, 64. It will come here. 55 to 64. Okay. Then 57 will come again here. Then 61 here. Then 67 will come in this column. 53 here. Then 39 will come in first. Then 50 will come here. Then 66 here. 81 will be 75 to 84. 49 here. 54 will be here. Then 88 here. Then 78, okay. Then 64 will come here. Then 35 will be in first column. Then 69 in between this. 46 will be here. 52 will be again here. 73 is here. 59 again will be here. 72 here. Then 87 here. 44, 82 will come here. Okay, so like that 30 students marks are there. So now we will do here total 3, here 7, then 5, then 6, then 5, then 4. Okay, 7, 3, 5, 6, 5, and 4. Now we need to do addition. 7 plus 3, 10, 15 plus 6, 21 plus 5, 26 plus 4, 30. Total is 30. Okay, so this is the distribution with the help of discontinuous class intervals. With the help of discontinuous class intervals. Okay, so now after this, we are going to see continuous class intervals. Okay, so with the help of this continuous, why continuous is required? Continuous is required because if someone will get marks in decimal, suppose 44.5 or 44 and half marks someone will get, so that is 44.5, correct? So in which class interval we need to write it? Okay, whether it will come here or here, that is the problem. Understood? So such type of conditions we need continuous class intervals. So how to convert continuous class intervals, that also we are going to see. Okay, so here class boundaries, class mark, that we are going to see in that. Okay, so see carefully, here I am taking class boundaries, class mark, or true class also we can say, class boundaries, okay, or true class. Now I told you, suppose someone will get 44.5 marks, then in which interval the marks will come, okay, which interval we need to do its entry. Okay, so now in this case, what we need to do, the upper limit of the first interval or any interval, upper limit plus lower limit of the next interval, lower limit of next class interval, we have to do the sum of these two divided by 2. Okay, so what will come here? 44 plus 45 divided by 2. 44 plus 45 will be 89 divided by 2. correct? 89 divided by 2, what is going to come? 2 4s are 8, 2 4s are 8, 44.5, 44.5, okay? So 44.5, so we need to convert this into 44.5, we need to convert this into 44.5, so that I am showing here only. These are actual class intervals. Here I am making one more call. Okay, when we want to make it is continuous, that time how to do that we are going to see. Okay, so these are actual class. Okay, now these are actual class. And again it will come tally marks and everything. Okay, we have its observations. Here we do not have any reading like this 44.5 or 46.5, we do not have. So this is okay. Okay, but if someone will get 44.5, then how to write that we are seeing here. Understood? So what will come? This is class and actual class. What is going to come? This is going to come 44.5. So this upper limit will come 44.5 to 54.5. Okay. Here what is going to come? 35. So 35.5. Here 54.5 will come here. Okay. 54. This will go 64.5. Then again 64.5, then it will come 74.5, 74.5 to 84.5, 84.5 to 94.5. Okay, is now suppose someone will get 44.5 marks, then it will come in the next interval that we have seen. Okay, 44.5 marks suppose someone will get, then that will come in the next interval. Okay, suppose someone will get 64.5 marks, then the entry we need to do in this interval. Okay, so this way we need to do. How to convert this? We have seen lower observation, any take. Suppose you will take 54.54 plus 55 if you have taken divided by 2. So what is going to come? 909 upon 2. So 2 5s are 10, 54.5. Okay, so this we have converted 54.5. This will be 54.5, 64. That way we have to come back or we have to go forward. Okay. So like that we need to convert actual class when in such type of conditions. Okay. And then tally marks will come like this. And a frequency. Just now I told you someone will get 44.5 marks. We need to enter in the next. Okay. Where 44.5 is the upper limit. This is the upper limit. Okay. This was the key. And last point was class interval. Class mark. We have seen that is class mark. We need to see. Class mark. Class mark is the mid value. Class mark is the mid value. See, this is 35 plus 44. This is one class interval. So how to find out class mark? 35 plus 44 divided by 2. Okay, so 9 plus 89, 5 plus 4, 9, 4 plus 3, 7. 79 by 2. So 2 3 is a 6, 2 9 7 8, 39.5 is the class mark. Okay, is the class mark. So we have seen some information regarding this. Okay, we will solve some more example and you will understand. Okay, but these are the things why continuous classes are required and why discontinuous classes are required, that is important. Okay, otherwise tally marks and frequency, you know that, you know very well. And where to write this 44.5 or 64.5, in which interval we need to write, that we have seen, we have discussed. Okay.